grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen. And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who have prepared for those who love you good things which no eye can see, fill our hearts, we pray, with the warmth of your love, so that loving you in all things and above all things, we may attain your promises which surpass every human desire. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The word of the Lord came to me. Son of man, prophesy against the shepherds of Israel. In these words, prophesy to them. Thus says the Lord God, woe to the shepherds of Israel who have been pasturing themselves. Should not shepherds rather pasture sheep? You have fed off their milk, worn their wool, and slaughtered their fatlings. But the sheep you have not pastured. You did not strengthen the weak, nor heal the sick, nor bind up the injured. You did not bring back the strayed, nor seek the lost, but you lorded it over them harshly and brutally. So they were scattered for the lack of a shepherd, and became food for all the wild beasts. My sheep were scattered and wandered all over the mountains and high hills. My sheep were scattered over the whole earth, with no one to look after them or to search for them. Therefore, shepherds, hear the word of the Lord. As I live, says the Lord God, because my sheep have been given over to pillage, and because my sheep have become food for every wild beast for lack of a shepherd, because my shepherds did not look after my sheep, but pastured themselves and did not pasture my sheep, because of this, shepherds, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God, I swear I am coming against these shepherds. I will claim my sheep from them and put a stop to their shepherding my sheep, so that they may no longer pasture themselves. I will save my sheep, and they will no longer be food for their mouths. For thus says the Lord God, I myself will look after and tend my sheep. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads them, he refreshes my soul.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage.
The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want.
You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows.
The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want.
Only goodness and kindness will follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is none I shall not want.
Hallelujah.
discern the reflections and thoughts of the heart.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out at dawn to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with them for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. Going out about 9 o'clock, he saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and he said to them, "You too go into my vineyard, and I will give you what is just." So he went off. And went out again around noon, and around 3 o'clock, and did likewise. Going out about 5 o'clock, he found others standing and said to them, "Why do you stand here idly all day?" They answered, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You too go into my vineyard." When it was evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, "Summon the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first." When those who had started about 5 o'clock came, each received the usual daily wage. So when the first came, they thought they would receive more, but each of them also got the same usual wage. And on receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last ones worked only 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us, who bore the day's burden of the heat." He said to one of them in reply, "My friend, I am not cheating. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what is yours and go. What if I wish to give this last one the same as you? Or am I not free to do as I wish with my own money? Are you envious because I am generous? Thus the last will be first, and the first will be last." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Are you jealous of what they're asking? The idle vineyard or workers in the parable aren't loafers. They're laborers who need a job. The fact that they're still waiting at 5 p.m. shows how badly they need work. In Jesus' time, if a man didn't find work today, his family often didn't eat tomorrow. A man who found work early in the morning rejoiced all day, and so did his family. Had the early workers not learned, the employer paid, if the early worker, pardon me, had the early workers not learned, the employer paid his latecomers a full wage, they would have gone home happy, joyful. As it was, they went home angry. The latecomers stand for the repentant sinners. The early workers stand for those Pharisees who resented sinners because the kingdom, entering the kingdom late and getting the same reward they did. The question for us, do we ever find ourselves resenting the good fortune of others? Lord, help us rejoice when our brothers and sisters are blessed, for indeed, we are all God's children. Let us pause here to offer our petitions to our Father.
This Mass is offered for the repose of the soul of Robert Kowalski. For this intention, let us continue to pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis and all bishops, may they be strengthened by the Holy Spirit in their priestly ministry. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all rulers and national leaders, may the Lord open their eyes to the need to treat all their citizens with human dignity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For educational leaders, that God will inspire them with creative options for opening classes in the fall that will help students learn and keep students and faculty safe. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
financial abortion, and for the legal protection of unborn children everywhere. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our military troops engaged in dangerous missions, that they may be protected by God watching over them and return safely to their families. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, may the Spirit help us grow in faith and virtue. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our people departed, including Nancy McCune, for whom Our Lady of Grace Candle burns this week, may they now rejoice in God's heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our personal petitions, let us pause in silence. For all of these, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to abortion and euthanasia throughout the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Mighty Father, we ask you to hear the prayers which we bring before you humbly. In Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Receive our oblation, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given, we may merit to receive your very self, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. So with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end, we acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy,
holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the new fire, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord, Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us.
Save your world.
By your cross and resurrection, we have set the heavens free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. We make thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Katz, our Pope, and Oscar, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, and the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a nod of peace. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. My ladies and gentlemen, we're quite good this morning to bring the new Christian ministers here. Let us pray. Made partakers of Christ through these sacraments, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that conformed to his image on earth, we may merit also to be his co-heirs in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.